welcome back to India Post Live, India's first live news interactive conversation web portal. I'm Hisyamu Bhutia. Data Sacha saw that Chief Gurmeet Ram Rahim Singh has been dominating the Twitter trends in the past couple of days. Thanks to his yet-to-be-released movie, MSG, Messenger of God, hashtags like We Support MSG, I Love MSG, Ban Drugs and Not MSG have been some of the top Twitter trends in the past couple of days. Followers of Gurmeet Ram Rahim Singh have come out in large numbers to support the movie. Well, what is the controversy all about? Well, before I begin the conversation, let's take a look at the trailer of the movie. And mind you, the movie has hit 2 million hits on YouTube so far.
कोई हमें संत कहता है, कोई कहता है फरिश्ता, कोई कहता है गुरु, तो कोई कहता है भगवान, लेकिन हम तो हैं सिर्फ एक इंसान.
Well, something which I forgot to mention earlier was that the movie has the movie's release date, which was supposed to release on January 17, but has now been deferred by the censor board, saying because the censor board feels that it might incite communal violence. Well, to take this conversation forward, I have with me online guests. I'm joined by C.S. Venkateshwaran from Trivandrum and Suman Gangopadhyaya from Patna. Welcome, Suman and Mr. C.S. Venkateshwaran.
Hi, Namaskar.
Hello. Sir, so let me first come to you, Mr. Venkateshwaran. So are you there online, sir?
Yeah, I can hear you.
Yeah. So your opening comments on this entire MSG controversy.
The thing is like, what is happening is like during the last 4 years, what is happening is you already have a censor board and also censorship rules and all that, which itself is a kind of redundant kind of institutions and structures. Second thing is even, you know, these institutions are being short-circuited by other kinds of communal and, you know, other interests, which is very sad actually.
Okay, sir. So the censor board has given its reason that the movie does not have any storyline. It's a self-glorification, a 192-minute of one person's advertisement. What do you say about that?
Well, the thing is, the censor board is not an authority to judge a movie. A movie, you know, is a person's or a group's a creative expression, which goes through the censor board and goes to the people to watch. So it is not for the censor board to judge whether a movie is good or bad. Maybe they have certain rules by which they have to, you know, see whether there are certain scenes to be cut or whatever. After that, they have no business to judge on a movie like that.
So you feel that the movie should be, you know, released and let the audience decide whether to trash it or not.
Yeah, in any free democratic country, you know, you should allow expression, freedom of expression, and let us have, you know, different kinds of voices, you know, critiquing it or, you know, talking for and against it and all that. Let us not consider people as children who have to be guarded against certain kinds of expressions and all that.
Okay. We'll just come back to you, sir. Can I have Suman online, please?
Yes, ma'am.
So, Suman, what's your first reaction on this entire MSG controversy?
Ma'am, actually, I'm confused because this is the first film which has been banned before its release, right? Mm-hmm. We have seen in the past that many films have been banned after release, but it's such a unique film that it has been banned before its release. Let me tell you that a film is the expression of a society, what people think, and on that front, a film has been made. But if someone thinks that he is a messenger of God and he created a film, made a film on that front. So it's okay. Let's people, people are there to watch that film. Because you know we have films in the past like Oh My God, where people where Akshay Kumar has projected himself to be Krishna. So if a film like that can be put on a screen and to the janta, why not this film? There should be no ban on the film, and this censor board actually works. I think has some nefarious ideas, and that's the why it bans films. Every film should be released, whether it's good and bad. It's the people who decide whether a film is bad or good. It's not the censor board. And ma'am, I must tell you that if a film like Hamshakal can be released and people are can watch those films also, so any film can be seen. So that is the thing, that a messenger of God should be given the permission that it should be, that people should go and watch. If they don't like, we have courts, we move to the courts and get something on that thing.
So, Salman, how is the mood in Punjab? Like, are people supporting MSG or, in Patna, are people saying that, you know, the censor board should just give a go ahead, or are they, you know, protesting against the movie?
Ma'am, actually here, people don't give a damn about this film. Film aaya to acha, nahi aaya to bhi acha. They want to, trailer is very, you know, catchy, full of actions and all those things. So yes, you can see if this film is released, we are getting a new action hero in form of Baba Ram Rahim, who can give too much of threat to Shah Rukh Khan and all those people in movies in the future. So we should give him up as a chance, and the censor board should be censored at all, because it's a useless piece of shit we have seen in the past. And the people who have are right now in the censor board, they should, I have no expectations from them also, frankly speaking. With the Modi Sarkar, so people are also, I think they are also right-wing people, and they have some ideas of their own. So the neutral peoples are not there. Whether it is Leela Sam Singh or Mr. Nehlani, I think this censor board, the concept and the iota of censor board should be banned at all. It's my view.
Okay, yeah. Thank you, someone. We'll just get back to you. If can I have a CS Venkateshwan online, please?
Yeah.
Yes, sir. So Suman seems to be in agreement with you on that. But sir, I wanted to ask you a very interesting thing. Like, this MSG has seen a lot of, you know, Twitter activism lately. You know, hashtags like "We support MSG" and "Ban drugs, not MSG." And that's why at India Post Live, we are asking: Is Gurmeet Ram Rahim Singh the new Twitter king? So do you think this Twitter activism is, you know, helping his movie?
Yeah, I think it will definitely help. It says that what is happening is you have this whole, you know, social media network very alive around cinema, but actually if you look at cinema as such, you know, cinema is actually almost dead. You know, it doesn't, people don't go to theaters and watch movies, and the cinema as it existed is no longer there. But you have all these kinds of social media circles very active around it, creating a lot of furor and a lot of, you know, hype. So actually the film is happening elsewhere, not the theatres or in the film text itself.
Okay, so also the censor board has said that in the movie, Ram Rahim Singh, the one of the reasons why the censor board has objected to this movie is that because the censor board is saying that Ram Rahim Singh has projected himself as God, and he's seen curing terminal ill diseases which are beyond any logic. So do you think the censor board only clears, you know, logical movies?
No, I think that is nonsense. I think any expression can have all kinds of, you know, it doesn't have to be logical, it doesn't have to be realistic. And it is not the business of censor board to impose certain kinds of, you know, aesthetic rules which should, you know, which the film should follow. Film can do whatever it wants. It can say whatever kind of story. And you know, it's another imaginary world where you are not, you know, shackled by all these logic. That is one thing. Second thing is, like, any film, for that matter, in a country like India, so many castes, so many societies, so many, you know, regions, languages, such diverse kind of country. You know, any film, any expression can hurt the sentiments of certain group of people. So where are we going to end up with? Unless we have certain kinds of non-negotiable values by which, you know, you protect freedom of expression, you protect people who want to express, and, you know, actually the state should be acting against people who are trying to hamper freedom of expression. But we see the state is working the other way around, which is sad.
Okay. So we'll just get back to you. We have Anit Mittal online. Anit Mittal is joining us from Bandala, Punjab. Anit, are you there? Hello. Can you hear me, Anit?
Hello, आवाज आ रही है मैम?
हाँ, Anit.
हम आज हमारे पंजाब में फिल्म वा.
हाँ, Anit, please.
आवाज नहीं आ रही.
अभी आ रही है मेरी आवाज आपको?
हाँ,
Anit, आप क्या कहना चाहेंगे इस पूरे about this whole controversy?
हमारे पंजाब में तो पूरी कंट्रोवर्सी हुई है, हो रही है.
अभी बरनाला में कैसे है मूड?
राजनीति कर रहे हैं. बरनाला में तो ठीक है, राजनीति के साथ राजनीति कर रहे हैं और क्या कर रहे हैं. फिल्म देखने के बाद ही बताना चाहिए ना इसमें क्या सीन जो सही है क्या नहीं सीन जो सही है. पहली रौड़ा रपा पाने से क्या होगा भी, पहली बैन कर दिया हमारे पंजाब में तो देखेगा फिर ही मालूम पड़ेगा ना ये सही है या गलत है. वो तो राजनीति कर रहे हैं कले बादल साहब और कुछ नहीं कर रहे. पहले तो बोलते थे भी हम बैन नहीं कर सकते फिल्म को, हमारे पास अधिकार नहीं, जो सेंसर बोर्ड का अधिकार है. अब बोलते पंजाब में इसका इफेक्ट पड़ेगा भी, माहौल खराब हो जाएगा, इसलिए हम फिल्म पे बैन करते. बार बार बादल साहब भी अपने बयान से पलट रहे हैं. पहले तो कहते हम बैन नहीं कर सकते, सेंसर बोर्ड के पास अधिकार है. फिर बोलते भी इससे माहौल नहीं सही रहेगा, हम भी बोलते हैं भी इसको बैन कर दिया जाए.
तो आप बैन के खिलाफ हैं या सपोर्ट में हैं?
मैं ये बोलना चाहता हूँ, जैसे हम कोई पिक्चर के तौर पे देखते हैं, फिल्म के तौर पे, तो उसको देखना चाहिए. उसके देखने के बाद उसका कोई रिप्ले आना चाहिए, पहले नहीं होना चाहिए. जैसे मैंने पीके देखी, बहुत अच्छी लगी. उसमें क्या है, उसमें बताया गया था भी जो बिना आप झंझट के काम करते रहते हो, कोई मान्यता नहीं है उसकी, ब्राह्मणों जैसे बनाए हुए है, उसको क्या मान्यता देने का फायदा. इसी में एक मैंने कल आर्टिकल भी देखा, एबी न्यूज का वालों का लिखा हुआ था. उन्होंने बोला भी, किसी ने लिखा था भी, जब हम मजार पे मत्था टेकते हैं किसी मंदिर में या मस्जिद में मत्था टेकते हैं, उसके बाद में हमें बोलते भी भगवान में इच्छा होनी चाहिए. इसमें भी राम रही ने वैसे ही किया है. उन्होंने लिखा भी आर्टिकल में, इसमें क्या दिक्कत है, जब उनको नहीं कोई दिक्कत, हम मत्था टेकते उनको अच्छा लगे तो वो भी अच्छा कर लेते. हम तो ये कहते हैं मूवी आनी चाहिए पहले.
तो आप देखने जाएंगे मूवी Anit?
हाँ जी, देखना चाहेंगे. देखने के बाद ही पता चलता ना. okay. लिटरेचर है, सीखने के बाद ही पता मालूम चलता अच्छा या बुरा है.
ओके Anit, हम बस आप We'll just get back to you. Well, we at India Post Live had tried to contact Dera Sachas or the spokesperson, and the spokesperson was supposed to come online, but I don't know, due to some unfortunate reason, he or she is not able to join us. Maybe we can wait if the person can join us. I have a question for C.S. Venkateshwaran.
Yeah,
sir. So the censor board, everyone seems to be in agreement that the censor board should not ban the movie right away. You know, let the viewers watch and then, you know, let them trash it or accept it. But in such an, you know, if that's the question, so what is the sole purpose of a censor board?
I think the censor board, as I said, is a redundant kind of thing. In this, you know, 24/7 internet era, censor board doesn't actually make any sense. But, you know, the problem is, like, in a country like India, which, you know, with so many hurtable sentiments around, so you need some sort of body to, you know, the state intervenes, you know, or acts as a kind of, you know, a referee in these kinds of things. And it should not go beyond that. And all these, whatever censorship rules, if at all that such a board should exist, should have a kind of, you know, set of rules which are you know, framed in a consensual manner. So it has to have very broad kind of, you know, it has to take into account freedom of expression of people and not not go by these kinds of standards, because the problem is like, if you say it will hurt the sentiments of somebody, it will cause a riot. This kind of, you know, this hurt sentiment narrative could actually, in the long run, could hurt and hamper freedom of expression. So we can invoke this sentiment at any moment, and you can actually curb expression. And you can act against anyone, just like Perumal Murugan or Bo, which is very sad. Country is democratic, let narratives thrive, you know, let a lot of people talk, let different kinds of perspectives come and face each other, dialogue with each other. Then, you know, that is what democracy is all about. Not selecting what people want, some people selecting and choosing what people want or should not see and what all kinds of things.
Okay, sir. Suman, can I have Suman, please? Suman, are you there?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, so Suman, we're talking about the Twitter activism, the Twitter activism going behind this whole MSG thing. So whole MSG controversy. So do you think that is, you know, generating a lot of interest among the people?
Ma'am, negative publicity is also good publicity, right? So any film which is having a negative publicity is having a good publicity also. For example, take the example of PK, dialogues which has not been cut due to censor boards did not want to do so. Because it, frankly speaking, it hurted some Hindu sentiments, that's why. On the other hand, it created a publicity which earned it 400 crores for the film. So I always think that negative publicity is always, in a way, helps a film. And the directors are also involved in such kind of things. I don't know about this MSG issue, but I think somehow the negative publicity created in this film also is helping them widely, because in YouTube, 2 million hits due to the public negative issue of this whole film.
So what about
this
you,
film
Suman?
Should be, yes, ma'am.
So what about you, Suman? Would you go and watch the movie now, after all this?
Ma'am, first of all, it should be released. Yeah, I want to watch this film. A new hero is coming in the market. Okay. So how much, how he delivers dialogue, how he all kinds of things. So I want to move. See this film.
Okay, yeah,
a
thank
new hero for this.
I'm sure the movie will release, because the movie has the censor board has now deferred the release date, and it's now gone to the revising committee, which is gonna review the movie, and probably the movie is gonna see the light of the day. Anit, aap sun rahe meri awaaz? So Anit, हम अभी ये शो एंड करने वाले हैं, तो बिफोर आई एंड दिस शो, आपका कोई लास्ट कोई कमेंट्स थॉट्स?
ये चाहते भी मूवी मार्केट में आए, को मूवी देखनी चाहिए, उसके बाद कमेंट करना चाहिए.
Okay.
जो सेंसर बोर्ड का काम बनता है वो उनको करने दीजिए, जो सीन गलत है वो उसको कटना चाहिए, उसके बाद जितनी मूवी अच्छी है वो आनी चाहिए.
Okay, thank you, Anit. Thank you so much for joining us. So, Venkateshwaran, sir, your last comments on the entire thing.
Yeah, only thing is like, you know, let us not get bogged down by this disease and, you know, hurt sentiment, get caught in this hurt sentiment narrative. Like, let people decide. Let us not, you know, expressions. Let expressions thrive. Let people, you know, you should have the courage to take on, you know, somebody making fun of you, and also you should have the right to make fun of others.
Okay, well, thank you so much, sir. I thank all my panelists joining me on this conversation. Well, this all seems to be in the agreement that let the first movie release and then let the audience decide whether it hurts your sentiments or not. Well, what do you think? Leave your posts and leave your comments on www.indiapostlive.com. You can also tweet us at #IndiaPostLive or @IndiaPostLive, or you can also go to our Facebook page and post your comments there. Well, thank you so much for watching the show. Goodbye.